If you have already your COVID-19 vaccine or you are planning to do it, you may have some heavy metals exposure and toxicity. Heavy metals accumulate in our tissues, and in a long term, they can cause a lot of side effects. So this training is for you because I'm going to tell you which are the main dangers and the main sources for heavy metals and how to detoxify your body from them. Heavy metals toxicity, or also called heavy metals poisoning, affects millions of people and is the trigger of a lot of symptoms and chronic diseases that we would never think are related to heavy metals. Whenever we are exposed to heavy metals, they enter our bloodstream and penetrate cells of a lot of tissues where they remain stored for years. So in this training, I'm going to tell you which are the main sources for heavy metals so we can prevent those sources and which are the best ways to pull them out from your body. Dietary changes, supplements, anything you need to know to eliminate them from your body. But first, let's understand what are heavy metals. So heavy metals are elements that can be toxic and very dangerous even in low concentrations. And they are in nature. They are out there. Some of them are from nature. Some of them are coming from synthetic materials from industry. Some of the most common heavy metals that can lead to toxicity or poisoning include mercury, lead, arsenic, cadmium, aluminum, nickel, uranium, thallium, or any other like magnesium, iron, lithium, zinc, and calcium, which, as you can see, these are some of the ones that we find even in multi-minerals. These are minerals. So yes, a lot of conditions can get worse if we have very high levels of essential minerals also in our body. That can also be dangerous. So this is why when we take a multi-mineral, it has to be controlled by a health practitioner first. So which is the danger of heavy metals? The danger or dangers, because there's more than one, of heavy metal poisoning, describes a number of health problems caused by exposure to environmental metals that accumulate inside the body. So according to a report in Scientific World Journal, toxic metals such as arsenic, cadmium, lead, and mercury have not beneficial role in human homeostasis and contribute to chronic diseases. So what are the main signs and symptoms of heavy metal poisoning? And maybe you have some of the symptoms and the doctor has put a different name for that. Some of the most common are chronic fatigue, autoimmune diseases, like for example, Lyme's disease, poor recovery from exercise and weakness, skin irritation, neurological disorders, brain fog, travel concentrated, difficulty learning, or memory fog. This is something that I hear from a lot of people. Memory fog, depression, maniac depression, or anxiety, dementia, insomnia, like having constant sleep problems. If they're not related to hormones, they can be related to heavy metals. Digestive issues like IBS issues, chronic aches and pain, and for example, fibromyalgia, like my mother had in the past, and she had high mercury contamination. Tremors, impaired motor control, hearing, speech, vision, anemia, high risk for heart attacks. As you can see, a lot of things that we would never think would be related to heavy metals, they are related to heavy metals. So where do heavy metals come from? This is very important so we can try to control those sources. So exposure to environmental pollutants, like for example, traffic fumes, and imagine we are in traffic jam, we are driving all the time. So traffic fumes is a big source for heavy metals, air pollution, food contaminants, cigarette smoke, or radiation. Also having metal amalgam dental fillings. If you have silver fillings, slowly release mercury into your body. Eating a poor quality diet, always diet first. Because for example, eating farm-raised fish that carry high levels of mercury is a big source. According to the Environmental Protection Agency, the most common way we are exposed to mercury is by consuming fish you shouldn't eat. that contains health hazardous heavy metals, such as tilefish, swordfish, shark, king mackerel, and big-eyed tuna. So this goes for farm fish, but this also goes for wildcat fish. The bigger the fish, the longer the life, the more mercury contamination. So it's very important to stick to the low mercury fish, that is small, the small fish. A diet that includes processed foods, especially those that are imported from other countries and not organically grown, and even plant foods grown in soil that have high levels of metals can also contribute to those factors. Drinking water that is contaminated with trace amount of metals is also a big source. Also from birth, we can get heavy metals. The mother has heavy metals that go to the uterus and then offspring to the baby. So from birth is also very, very common contamination. Exposure or use of households, this is a big trigger. Household substances that carry mercury, such as adhesives that are everywhere, air conditioned filters, cosmetics, fabric softeners, felt, floor waxes and polishes, and talcum powder. So as you can see, mercury is everywhere. So trying to substitute all the hygiene and cleaning products for the natural approach in the house is a must. Tattoos. Tattoos is also a big cause of heavy metals toxicity. Exposure to substances that carry lead, like for example, chocolate. Some of the chocolates have lead. Canned foods, toothpaste, old paints, insecticides, ceramic or some pottery, and some pipes. So very, very important to be sure that we avoid also these products. Also, the use of exposure or other type of household items. As you can see, household items have everything, mercury, lead, everything. So other type of household items are like baking powder. It's very important to buy a baking powder without aluminum. Antiperspirant, some baby formulas, very dangerous, plastic toys, antacids, aluminum foil. It's a big source of aluminum. Metal pots and pans, stainless steel, coins, and a lot of makeup. So very important also to try to use natural makeup. And vaccinations, vaccines. A lot of vaccines have heavy metals, and this goes for any type of vaccine. So if you are a person that has been going through also recently COVID vaccine, one of the things that you should start doing is detoxify from heavy metals exposure. So in high amounts, mercury and other heavy metals are some of the deadliest metals, mostly mercury. So can you die from heavy metals poisoning? Well, it is rare, it is possible, but in some severe cases. And I'm going to give you an example, and that is my uncle. My uncle is very young, and he suffers from ALS, which is a terminal sclerosis, and he has been a plumber before for many, many years. So he has been exposed to lead, mercury, a lot of heavy metals coming from the plumbing system. So the amount of metals that he has in his body is so high that even chelation treatment wasn't able to eliminate it. And he has ended up with a terminal sclerosis. So yes, heavy metals at some point can cause really severe issues and sometimes deadly. So what is a heavy metal detox? If someone has reason to believe that they have had excessive exposure to metals, they should seek medical testing for metal poisoning by speaking with me or their doctor or other integrative practitioner or naturopath. Because heavy metal testing is the form that we can use to test if you have any heavy metal poisoning by hair analysis, urine, or even blood test. I personally like the best the hair. And that will be confirming the toxicity. So even if you choose not to be tested for toxicity, many of the diet and lifestyle changes that I'm going to talk about here today will still be beneficial for immune system function, gut health, liver function, and more. The primary goal of a heavy metal detox is to remove accumulated heavy metals from your brain and nervous system. The kidneys, liver, heart, lymphatic system, and respiratory system will also benefit from detoxification, such as a liver cleanse. So how are toxins removed from the body? The most common way is through chelation. Chelation therapy is a medical procedure, but it can also be performed at home, that involves the administration of chelating agents to remove heavy metals from the body by binding to molecules and allowing them to be dissolved and excreted through the urine. So chelation is a central to natural detoxification of heavy metals because it works with glutathione, which is an amino acid very important for detoxification, and other small molecules to promote excretion. It is recommended that it be performed by a practitioner since serious side effects are possible, such as removal of essential minerals and cognitive impairment. So chelation is something that is very extreme already when the person has really, really high levels of heavy metals. Other ways to detoxify the body of heavy metals include making dietary changes, using herbs and supplements, which help to break down metals into smaller molecules so we can remove them through the urine, feces, sweat, and even the breath. So which are the benefits of doing a heavy metals detox? Reduce free radical damage and oxidative stress, like heavy metals cause a lot of damage in our tissues. Improvement in energy levels, enhance immunity and gut health. Better digestive function. Our gut can get a lot of dysfunction and bacterial dysbiosis if we have heavy metal poisoning. Improvements in mental performance, like having more attention, memory, learning. You are not going to have more memory fog anymore. You are going to improve skin health because a lot of the oxidative stress and free radical damage affects the skin. So a lot of skin conditions will improve as well. And better protection against diseases, cognitive disorders, and autoimmune diseases because our immune system is going to be stronger. So which are the foods that you want to eat while you are doing a heavy metal detox? So leafy green veggies, like for example, greens are some of the most powerful heavy metal detox foods. So try to have a type of bitter greens each day, like kale, Swiss chards, dandelion greens, mustard greens, arugula, spinach, or beet greens. Also, broccoli sprouts is one of my favorites, are another great food for providing antioxidants, eliminate free radical tissue damage, and reduce inflammation. Another one is herbs and spices. Herbs and spices are anti-inflammatory, antioxidant herbs and spices like basil, parsley, oregano, rosemary, thyme, ginger, and turmeric, really good for decreasing inflammation. Cinnamon and cilantro can help remove heavy metals, really, really efficient. Mostly cilantro, with other green herbs and plants, is one of the best herbs for detoxifying and can help reduce the buildup of heavy metals like mercury and lead in our body. So try to add herbs like cilantro and parsley to fresh squeezed juices or every single food that didn't add some cilantro and parsley. But in juices, you have it even more concentrated. Also, foods rich in vitamin C. Fruits and vegetables rich in vitamin C can reduce the damage caused by heavy metal toxicity by acting as an antioxidant. So high vitamin C foods include citrus fruits like oranges and grapefruit. You don't have to go on a low-carb diet. Also, leafy greens like spinach and kale, all type of berries, broccoli and cruciferous vegetables, kiwi, papaya, guava, and bell peppers if you don't have to go on a nightshade-free diet. If you are not sensitive to FODMAP, garlic and onions are also some of my favorites. These vegetables contain sulfur, which helps your liver detoxify itself of heavy metals like lead and arsenic. Then, of course, drinking a lot of water, and this is something that people don't really do much. You need to drink 8 ounces of water or vegetable juice every 2 hours. 8 ounces of water is like a cup. So 1 cup of water or veggie juice every 2 hours to stay hydrated and help flush out toxins. Very, very important on a detox. Flax seeds and chia seeds. So these provide omega-3 fatty acids and fiber that can help with detoxifying of the colon and reduce inflammation. By increasing the fiber, improve bowel movement, which is one of the best ways to eliminate heavy metals. Bone broth. Bone broth helps to keep you hydrated, provides important minerals, and supports liver health by providing glutathione. It also provides amino acids that help strengthen the organs. Consume bone broth by either making your own and sipping on several cups daily, or by using collagen powder. That's also one of my favorites. Then foods to avoid while detoxing include farm fish. As we said, farm fish is a big cause of heavy metals, or even wildcat fish that is very big, like for example, tilefish, swordfish, shark, king mackerel, and tuna, big sources of heavy metals. You can continue eat fish several times a week, but make sure that you make better choices that are low in mercury and purchase wildcat fish that is small. Food allergens. If your body is fighting against common allergens, like for example, peanuts, as there is a drawing in here, and dealing with high levels of inflammation, it will not be able to detoxify from heavy metals. So it's very important to deal with allergies and inflammation first, and then you will start detoxifying. So very, very important to work on food allergies. Non-organic foods, and I mentioned this already before, non-organic foods, these foods increase exposure to chemicals, which make symptoms worse. I would say that stick to the list designed by the Environmental Working Group, EWG.org, the Dirty Dozen and the Clean 15. The Dirty Dozen are the ones that you have to completely avoid, or buy organic, because they have a lot of pesticides and they are a big source of heavy metals. Foods additives. Additives may aggravate toxicity symptoms and decrease your body's ability to detoxify. Also, alcohol. Too much alcohol is toxic to the body and can make it more difficult for your liver to process other toxins. So it's not that alcohol is a big source of heavy metals, but impair the capacity of detoxification because it affects your liver, which is one of the main organs involved in detoxification. Then beside diet, ideally, you can start incorporating also certain supplements. Like for example, chlorella is one of my favorite. Number one, chlorella is a type of green algae that acts as a natural chelator to remove heavy metals, especially lead and mercury. It is a great source of chlorophyll and is hungry to absorb other metals. You can take it in powder form or tablet form. Then vitamin C, as we said, vitamin C rich foods are important, but in higher concentration, vitamin C acts as an antioxidant to help reduce free radical tissue damage. Cilantro, also in the form of tincture or essential oil, is really concentrated. My other favorite is Silajit, which is something that I tell all my patients to start taking from day number one, because Silajit is an adaptogenic plant that has certain things in common with activated charcoal, especially that it contains a lot of carbon. So it's a natural chelator because it contains fulvic acid and humic acid that bind to toxin molecules. So it has a lot of minerals, but it's also a really good way to detoxify. Milk thistle. Milk thistle is one of the most popular herbs for detoxifying the liver. It acts as a toxin blockade agent by inhibiting binding of toxins to cell membrane receptors. So it's also very good to reduce liver injury and is used to treat alcoholic liver disease, acute or chronic viral hepatitis, and toxin-induced liver diseases. Milk thistle in the tea form or the supplement form is a must. And then probiotics, because the probiotics help improve detoxification of the gut, which can be we can have a lot of accumulation of heavy metals in there and help boost immunity. Really, really important. And then other treatments, so for example, chelation therapy. It is one of the most effective, but it's usually when there are very, very high contamination of lead, mercury, aluminum, and arsenic. So chelation therapy involves a chemical solution called EDTA, which is administered into the body, typically directly into the bloodstream via injection. So it can bind with excess minerals. EDTA chelation therapy helps to eliminate metals by binding salts to molecules. After EDTA attaches to heavy metals, together they both move to the kidneys where they are eliminated through the urine. So most people need between 5 to 30 chelation sessions to see the best results. So while it is considered to be generally safe, side effects are possible. So it's why this is very important that you do it with a healthcare practitioner. Then activated charcoal. This is one of my favorite that is possible to do it at home. Activated charcoal is a treatment that works to eliminate metals and toxins via adsorption or the chemical reaction where the element binds to a surface. So the surface of activated charcoal has a negative electricity that causes positive charged toxins and gas to bind to it. So charcoal is so powerful that it is used as an emergency treatment even for removing poisons from the body very, very fast. Bentonite clay is another one. Bentonite clays are used to absorb toxins because they act like a sponge or magnet for chemicals and metals inside the body. So due to its polycationic nature, bentonite clay leads to absorption of negative charge toxins. So activated charcoal pulls positive charge toxins and clay moves negative charge toxins. Another one is Triphala. Triphala is an additional Ayurvedic herbal formulation made from the dried powder of 3 different fruits that contain the strong antioxidants called gallic acid, ellagic acid, and cibulinic acid. Triphala has antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and anti-diarrheal abilities. Consuming Triphala can help to cleanse the digestive tract, relieve constipation, and produce regular bowel movements, which are important for removing metals, bacteria, and excess fatty acids from the body. So what is happening during detoxification? So when you begin to detoxify, certain symptoms can be expected as your body starts to acclimate. Before you wind up feeling better and seeing improvements in your health, you might actually feel worse at first for a brief period of time. So this is a sign that your body is going through changes that might not feel very great, but ultimately they will leave you healthier once you get through them. So always, always when we detoxify, we go through a withdrawal process. We have to pass that withdrawal. It lasts like 1 to 2 weeks. And then you are going to start feeling your best. So what are the side effects of detoxifying that you may get? Your symptoms may be even worse than they were before. So it's gas and bloating, nausea and vomiting, diarrhea and constipation, headaches, skin rashes, changes in appetite, low energy, or even metallic taste. This is something that I hear from a lot of people, that they have metallic taste or sour taste before they start detoxifying. When we test for heavy metals, they're usually positive. But the metallic taste tend to increase during the withdrawal and then it will go away. So how long can you expect it to take for a heavy metal detox to begin working? It really depends on how high your levels are, the sources of exposure, and the efforts you are making to get rid of them. If you are really into it, you may detoxify faster than if you are not really working on it. So remember that heavy metal exposure slowly takes place over many years. So getting rid of them will not happen overnight. So patience, as I always say, is the key to success. very, very important to identify if you have heavy metals toxicity. As you can see, a lot of the symptoms that you may have now may be related to heavy metals toxicity. So contact me. We can do a test if in your hair is the one that I like the most. Hair and urine are more accurate than a blood test. So we can start doing a detoxification, because if you have high levels of metals contamination, I have talked about a lot of the foods and a lot of the supplements that are important, but it's important that you are also monitored during the whole detox, because a lot of side effects could come along. But remember that the first step is to test for heavy metals. So you can also find in the description of the video how to contact me so we can move forward into measuring those heavy metals in your body. Remember, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel so you can get more weekly notifications for more healthy tips to improve your health. And I hope to see you in the next video.